everyone, this is Imran Pardesi sir, and today I will be continuing standard 8, chapter number 6, factorization of an algebraic expressions. Okay, so look at the board. Today we will solve practice set 6.3. Yesterday we have seen 6.2. In that we have used this formula: first term cube plus second term cube. Then we have to write first term plus second term, first term plus second term, right? Then square of the first term minus first term multiply by second term plus second term square. This formula we have used yesterday to solve the factorization. Today we will see practice set 6.3. In this we will use this formula, which is exactly like this, but here the change is sign. Okay, please pay attention. A cube means first term cube minus second term cube. Is it clear? See, A cube minus B cube. First we will write A first term minus second term. See, first term minus second term. First we will write first term minus second term. Then we will write square of the first term plus first term multiply by second term plus second term square. Okay, again I will explain this formula. Today we will utilize this formula in practice set 6.3. look at here: first term cube minus second term cube. First we will write first term minus second term, first term minus second term. Okay, then we will write square of the first term plus first term multiply by second term plus second term square. This formula we will utilize in this practice set 6.3. look at the board. Practice set 6.3, question number 1, factorize. We have to factorize this is two terms. Yes, y cube. 27 is a cube of which number? 27 is a cube of 3. Yes, it means 27 is already in the cubic form. Is it clear? So first we will copy the question as it is. Okay, y cube minus 27. Okay, then this 27 is already in the cubic form. We will write 27 is cube of which number? 3. So we will write y cube is a cube of y. Y cube is a cube of y minus 27 is a cube of 3. Is it clear? 27 is cube of 3. So now this is a and this is b. Now we will utilize when the two terms in cubic form and there is a sign minus between them. What you will do? First you will write first term minus second term. First term is what? Y minus second term. First term minus second term. Then square of the first term. What is first term here? Y square plus first term multiply by second term. That is y multiply by 3 plus second term square. Okay, that is 3 square. Understood? Now we will solve this. Y minus 3 as it is, y square plus 3 ones are 3y plus 3 square 9. This is the answer of these two cubic terms. Is it clear? This is how we have to solve. Now look at here the second one. First we will write the question as it is: x cube minus 64y cube. Can you see this cube is on y? It is not on 64. It means 64 is already in the cubic form. 64 is a cube of which number? 4. So first we will write the simple form: x cube is a cube of x. X cube is a cube of x minus 64 is a cube of 4 and y cube is a cube of y. Now this is a and this is b, first term and second term. How we have to solve when there are two cubic term and minus sign is there? First we will write first term minus second term, right? First term minus second term. Then we will write square of the first term, square of the first term plus multiplication of first term and second term, that is x multiplied by 4y plus, now we will write square of the second term, square of the second term. Now we will solve it: x minus 4y, x square plus 4 ones are, coefficient of x is here 1. So what you will say? 4 ones are 4x and y, right? Plus 4 square means 16 and y square means y square. So this is how we have to solve. We have to factorize two binomial terms which is in cubic form. Yes, x cube minus 64y cube. We have to solve like this. we have to use this formula a cube minus b cube. First you will write first term minus second term, right? First term minus second term, then square of the first term plus multiplication of first term and second term plus then second term square. This is this formula we have to utilize in practice set 6.3. Dear students, now we will see the next question of practice set 6.3. Please look at the board. Practice set 6.3, question number 1, factorize and third sum 27n cube minus 216n cube. We have to utilize this formula only. First term cube minus second term cube. First we will write first term minus second term, okay? Then we will write square of first term plus first term multiplied by second term plus second term square. Is it clear? Now please pay attention. We have to write this question first as it is. 27m cube minus 216n cube, okay? Now please pay attention here. 27 is already in the cubic form. This cube is on m, not on 27. This cube is on n, not on 216. So what we have to do? We have to write it simplest form. 27 is a cube of 3 and m cube is a cube of m. Okay? Minus 216 is cube of 6 and n cube is a cube of n. Is it clear? Now this is a and this is b. Now what will be the first step? Write first term minus second term. See, first term minus second term, okay? Now second step, first term square, 3m square plus first term multiplied by second term, that is 3m multiplied by 6n plus now second term square, okay? Now we have to solve this. 3m minus 6n, it means first term minus second term. Square of the first term, 3 square is 9, m square is n square plus 3 6 are 18 mn plus 6 square is 36 and n square is n square. This is the answer. Okay, I hope you understood. We have to use this formula. Now look at here the fourth one. First we will copy the question as it is. 125y cube minus 1. Why the 1 is simple here alone, not cube here? 1 cube is 1 only, therefore 1 is alone, okay? 1 cube is 1, 1 square is also 1, okay? So first we will make it simple. 125 is a cube of 5, so I will write 5y cube minus 1 cube, okay? Now this is a and this is b. First we will write a minus b, first term minus second term, okay? Then square of the first term, that is 5y square plus first term multiplied by second term, that is 5y multiplied by 1 plus second term square, that is 1 square. Okay, now we have to solve this. First term 5y minus second term 1, 5 square 25y square y square plus 5 ones are, this 5 multiplied to 1, 5 ones are 5, y as it is. Now 1 square is 1. This is the answer. This is how we have to solve these two cubic terms. Is it clear? This is how we have to solve. I hope you understood how to utilize this formula. Very easy, very simple. Now see the next question, question number 5 and 6. Very easy. Look at the board. First we will copy the question as it is. 8p cube minus 27 upon p cube, okay? See, 8 is already in the cubic form. 8 is a cube of 2, okay? 27 is cube of 3. So first we will write its simplest form. See, 2 and p cube is a cube of p, 2p cube minus 27 is a cube of 3 and p cube is a cube of p. Understood? This is cube of 2, this is cube of p, 27 is cube of 3 and p cube is cube of p. Now this is a and this is b. Now we have to write first term minus second term, that is 2p minus 3 upon p, first term minus second term. Now square of the first term, that is 2p square plus first term multiplied to second term, that is 2p multiplied by 3 upon p. This p and this p will get cancelled, okay? Plus square of the second term, 3p square. Is it clear? Now we will solve this, okay? See, 2p minus 3 upon p. First term minus second term. 2 square, 4. P square plus 2 remain. Multiply by 3. 2 and 3 remain. 2 threes are 6. Plus 3 square is 9 and p square is p square. So this is how we have to solve the factorization. Is it clear? It is very easy, very simple. Now see the question number 6. First we will copy the question as it is. 343 a cube minus 512 b cube. Now 343 is a cube of 7. So we will write 7. A cube is a cube of a. 7a cube minus 512 is a cube of 8 and b cube is a cube of b. So it is b, 8b bracket cube. Okay. Now this is a and this is b. So first we will write first term minus second term. Okay. Now we will give square to the first term. 7a square plus first term multiply to second term. 7a multiply by 8b plus now we will square second term square. Is it clear? Second term square. Now we will write the answer. 7a minus 8b. 7 square is 49. A square is a square plus 7 8s are 56. A multiply by b plus 8 square is 64 and b square is b square. So this is your answer. I hope you understood. Very easy and very simple how to factorize practice set 6.3. Now we will see the 7th question. Please look at the board. Copy the question as it is. 64x cube minus 729y cube. Okay. Now we have to see this cube is on x, not on 64. 64 is a cube of 4. X cube is a cube of x. Right? 729 is a cube of 9 and y cube is a cube of y. So now this is a and this is b. What is our first step? First term minus second term. Next, square of the first term, 4x square plus multiply the both the terms, 4x multiply by 9y plus square of the second term. Is it clear? Now see, this is 4x minus 9y. 4x square is 16, x square is x square. 4 9s are 36, xy plus 9 square is 81 and y square is y square. So this is how we have to solve the factorization. Dear students, now we will see practice set 6.3 question number 2 simplify. See, this is a term minus b. See, a square minus b square. This is a and this is b. Okay, a square minus b square. Same, we will utilize the same formula like question number 1. Okay, first copy the question. Okay, now we will take a minus b. This is a. X plus y. A minus x minus y. This is a minus b. First and second term. Okay, first term minus second term. Then what? Square of the first term. What is first term here? X plus y bracket square. Plus, first term will multiply to second term. Okay, that is x plus y multiply to x minus y, okay, plus square of the second term, that is x minus y bracket square. See, I have written here some formulas as we have learned this formula in 6th-7th standard. See, x plus y square, this is a plus b square, okay, x plus y bracket square, a plus b bracket square. So a and this is b. So what it will be? X square plus 2xy plus y square. Okay. So now see here, we will open this bracket. Open this bracket. This is x plus y minus x. This minus multiply to this minus will be plus y. See, x plus y minus x minus will multiply to minus here. It will be plus y. Now see, expand this x plus y bracket square. It will be x square plus 2xy plus y square, right? Now if there are two brackets and the sign is interchanged, you will say x will multiply to x, sign will multiply to sign and y will multiply to y. So it will be x square minus y square, okay, plus Again, this is x minus y bracket square, a minus b bracket square. So you will write x square minus 2a, 2xy minus 2xy plus y square. Okay, now we will see the same terms, like terms we will do addition or subtraction. X and x, how many? This x is positive, cut. This x is negative, cut. Okay, y plus y, 2y. Okay, now this 1x square, 2x square and 3x square, so total 3x square. This plus xy and this minus xy will get cancelled. Now how many y's are there? See, this y plus y and this minus y, it will also cancel. So what is remain from here? It is plus y square. Okay, so now we will multiply this to this, this to this, then this to this. 2 3's are 6, y, x square y plus 2 1's are 2, y cube. 2 1's are 2, here 1 is a coefficient. 2 1's are 2 and y will multiply to y square, it will be y cube. So this is the final answer of this first simplification. I hope you understood here. Dear students, now I will solve third one. Second one will be homework to you. This third one is different one. That's why I am solving here. Can you see something we have solved this before? Bracket a plus b bracket cube. Look at here. Bracket a plus b bracket cube. Give this cube to first term, a cube plus. Give this cube to both the terms in the multiplication form, but first term will carry square. Plus. Now give this cube to both the term, but now second term will carry the square, right? Plus give this cube to second term. This we had solved already before, right? Now first we will copy the question as it is. A plus b bracket cube minus a cube minus b cube. This is different question, right? We have solved this before. This kind of questions we have solved before. So now we will say we will solve this bracket. Give this cube to first term, that is a cube, plus give this cube to both the terms in the multiplication form, but here first term will carry the square, right? Now same we will copy, 3 multiplied by a, but now second term will carry the square, right? Plus now third term will carry the square. The remaining terms will be as it is, minus a cube minus b cube, right? Now solve this. A cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube minus a cube minus b cube, right? Now see, there are some terms which are opposite, they will get cancelled. See, a cube plus a cube and minus a cube will cancel here, right? Plus b cube and minus b cube will cancel here. Then what left? 3a square b plus 3ab square. This is your answer. I hope you understood how to solve this. Now see, we will solve the question number 4 of question number 2 simplify. First copy the question as it is. This is a cube and this is b cube. First term cube minus second term cube. Same method we will utilize. What we do first? First term minus second term. What is first term here? P minus p plus 1, second term. First term minus second term, right? Now later on what we do? Square of the first term, that is p square, plus first term will multiply to second term, p will multiply p plus 1, okay, plus. Now what is second term? P plus 1 bracket square, okay, p plus 1 bracket square. Now we have to solve this. See, open this bracket first, p minus p, this minus will multiply here, minus p, this minus will multiply to this plus, it will be minus 1, okay. Now again you will solve p square plus this p will multiply to p and 1. It is p is a p square plus p. Okay, p 1 is a p plus p. This is p plus 1 bracket square, means a plus b bracket square. This is a plus b bracket square. So what is a plus b bracket square? Is a square plus 2ab plus b square. This formula we will use here. A square means p square plus 2ab means p 1's are p, okay, p 1's are p and 1, right, 2 multiplied by p multiplied by 1 plus 1 square, right, 1 square. Now we will solve further. This capital positive p and negative p will cancel. What is remain here? Minus 1. Now see here, we will solve first p square plus p square plus p plus p square plus 2p. 2 ones are 2, 2p, right? 2 ones are 2, 2p. Plus 1 square is 1. 1 square is 1. Now we will solve this. See the similar words, same terms are there. P square, p square, p square. Total how many? 3p square. Plus 1p and 2p. How much? 3p. Plus 1, right? P square, p square, p square, 3p square. This is 1p, this is 2p. Total 3p. N plus 1. Now this minus 1 will multiply to all these trinomial terms. See, minus 1 threes are minus 3p square. Okay? Minus 1 multiply to minus 3, minus 3p. Minus 1 will multiply to plus 1, minus 1. Is it clear? Minus will multiply to plus, it will be minus 1, 1's are 1. So this is your answer. I hope you understood. Question number 2, simplify. Question number 2, second term and fifth one, you will solve as a homework. I hope you understood how to solve practice set 6.3. Thank you so much. Best of luck.